impact on health and on the environment, and it upheld that it was wrong for them to have profit. So that was a landmark decision. Also, looking at Bay, BT cotton that we're talking about in Nigeria, like I said, I mean, it's there. I'm a lawyer, I know the implication of not saying what is not true. They brought in that application exactly what was in Burkina Faso. The only thing they did was to look Burkina Faso and put in Nigeria. That BT cotton failed in Burkina. And they've said, the government said, we no longer want it. We're not going to have BT cotton. We're going to go our organic conventional cotton. So we take something that has failed, and we put an objection that if you go to our website, Home Health, you'll see we always said this was not going to work. And just for a few years down the line, if you read business, they came up with a report and said the farmers are already complaining that this thing is not working, that all the hype is not true. Even the cowpea, these people are afraid to tell people that they are using it. They like to hide it. Like I said, if you are hiding what you're not, you don't want people to know, that means you shouldn't be doing it. They don't want people to know it's true because people don't want it. It's a failed technology. Go around, their stories abound. There are evidence on ground to show that GMOs has failed. A typical example is in the US. Starlink was a variety of means that was engineered for animal consumption. It was called Saccharomyces. It was not meant for people to eat because of the allergicity of the protein that was in. They couldn't control it. They found it in the food chain and they recalled it, not just in the US, but it was all around. So you can imagine the US, if this can happen, how much in Nigeria? Can we contain what will happen? We're talking about food allergies. I went to Cuba recently for treatment. They didn't give me medicine, they gave me food. The food was medicine, the medicine was food. They said it was food was right to do well. So we're talking about our people. And a few corporations, this thing is not patent. These people take product and say, this is what God has given us. If you believe in God, I believe in God. Or nature, if you don't want to say. And then they tinker with it and then say, oh, we are the ones. You do not, when you contaminate a product that becomes receptive, you don't do anything. You contaminate it. You just want to. It's an empire built on the same lies, misinformation, and untruth. And we say, ban GMOs now. Ban it. Ban it.
Yeah.